So otherwise it's called periodic. Is that fine, everyone? Okay.
Yes, sir, yes.
So what do you think is the period of, okay, this is a not so very interesting example, right? So let's make this, okay, one here. So what is the period of four, state four? See, if I start at four, I can only go to one. If I start at one, I can go to either one or two, right? If I go to two, I can only go to three, or I can stay back at two. And three, I can go to either one or four, right? The minimum would be what? One, two, three, four. So P 4, 4 of 4 is greater than 0. So 4 is one of the numbers. What about 5? I can always do, right? At 3, I can take a stop and go back to 3 again and then come to 4. 5 is possible, right? 4 is possible, 5 is possible. What about 6? I can always do 6, right? I can stay back at 2 and come to 3 and stay back in 3 and come to 4. So 6 is also possible, 7 is also possible, and so on, right? What is the GCD of all those? 4, 5, 6, 7, etc. What is the GCD of that?
1, sir.
1, right? So it's an aperiodic state. Is the GCD clear? Well, we will see why this is useful soon, okay? Is that fine?
Yes, sir.
Now, there is a very interesting result. So, maybe let me not state the theorem. Maybe let me just try to convince you and then probably prove this theorem. Okay. Suppose I have, let's say, two classes. Okay. You know what class is, right? Of course, there is a link here. It's not separate class. So it's, okay. There are no both way communications, but only one way. Okay. You either go there and something like that. Okay. Okay. So now you have these two communicating classes. And suppose I have two nodes here, okay, I and J, okay, two nodes, okay. So now the period of node I is d of I, okay. What can you say about the period of node J? What is this? Can you say something about the two nodes? That's the question, right? So, what can you say about this? See, pictorially, this is what I can say, right? See, d of I is the greatest common divisor of the number of steps that you need in order for you to start at I and come back to I with non-zero probability, right? So, this is the greatest divisor. Now, I can go from I to J. Do you agree?
No. Yes, sir. And also J to I.
I cannot write it like this, but I can write like this, right? So you go to some, all the intermediate states and come back to J, right? So that means I can go from I to J in some n steps. Do you agree? Because it belongs to the same class, so there is some n for which Pijk n is greater than 0. Do you agree?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Okay. So, P I I going from I to I after some steps is also greater than 0. Do you agree? Well, after some step I won't write. After some step is also greater than 0, right? Do you agree? For example, some multiple of D of I, right? So that will be greater than 0. Now I can go from I to J in n step. Okay. I can go from J to M, right? So I can wander and go back, so J to I. So P, J, I after M step is also greater than 0. Do you agree? Do you agree?
But it can be a transient class also, I mean.
No, we have already proved that, right? If you have in a communicating class, you will either have a transient or recurrent, right?
Then this class can be a transient also. I mean, this whole thing.
Huh. So now, what will be the period of a transient class?
it can never come back.
Right?
Aperiodic.
It's not even aperiodic. It never comes back. Okay, let's not worry about let's assume for a moment that this is a
recurrent.
Recurrent. Okay, so let's see what happens if it's transient later. Okay, this is a recurrent. And therefore, all the nodes in the class is recurrent. Right? So now, Pji of m is greater than 0. Pij of n is greater than 0. Therefore, Pii of m plus n is also greater than 0. Do you agree? See, I can go from I to j in n step and from j to I in m step. Therefore, I can start at I and come back to I in m plus n step. This is fine, right?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Very clear. So, that means, this means d of I divides m plus n. Do you agree? It should, right? Why? D of I is the greatest common divisor of such PII of k, right? Greater than 0. So, if it divides, it's the greatest common divisor. Therefore, it should divide any step of any walk of length m plus n.
Yeah, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Is this clear, everyone? This is important.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Others?
Yes, sir.
Ayush?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I don't know whether Nitish is there. No, I don't see those guys. Okay. Praveen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now I'll do one more simple thing. See, I go to J. Okay. So let me write that as a separate diagram. I start at I go to J. Okay. So I wander and go to J. And then from J, I wander and come back to J. Okay. Is that fine? Is that fine? Okay. And then from J, I can come back to I. Okay. So what is this number of steps? This is N step. This is M step as before. N plus M. So there is a cycle from I to J and J to I, right? So N plus M cycle. Now, let's suppose that J to J, it takes T steps. What is this saying? P J to J in T step is greater than 0, right? Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
Right. Okay. Now, J to J in T steps. Now, Pi to I in M plus N plus T steps is also greater than 0, right? Do you agree? I can go from I to J with non-zero property in N step, and from J to J itself with non-zero property in T steps, and from J to M in non-zero property in M steps. So, the probability that I'm going from I to I in M plus T step is non-zero, right? Very clear. Because I can write this as a summation over all possible transitions and one of the term is this and therefore I can write this. Okay, is this fine, everyone?
Yes, sir, yeah.
So this implies D of I divides M plus N plus T also, right?
Yes, sir.
So now, what can you say about this thing now? What can you infer from this? Is this fine? What is... What can you infer from this? Can somebody tell me quickly?
Sir, we can infer something about DJ also.
What is that?
So from J to J, we can go in the same number of steps here, I think. Yeah.
Also, that's correct, right? D of J, right? That divides what? T. Do you agree? Why is that? Pjj of T is greater than 0. That means D of J, that is the greatest common divisor of J, divides T, right? You agree?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
So this implies D of I also divides T because why? It divides M plus N also. Therefore, it should divide. See, it also divides M plus N plus T. That means it should divide T, right? You cannot add some number.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Very simple, right? D of I divides T. So D of J also divides T. What can you say about the two?
concept.
What can you say? What can you say about this?
Multiple of each other, DI and DJ. DI and DJ, multiple of each other.
Can you argue out why that is the case?
Sir, DI divides T, that is T equal to some integer times DI.
Correct.
T equal to DJ divides T, so T equal to some other integer times DJ.
Let's write that. So some L times D of I equal to some K times D of J. Okay, so what? So what can you say from this?
It's like LCM. LCM.
Not really. So essentially this is the point, is this is true for every tree, right? This is true for every T. That is possible, of course, every T possible, right? So that means if you can pick any T such that PJJ of T is greater than zero, that means it's true for definitely for two T. Do you agree? If I can start at J and come back to J in T steps, I can also start from J and come back to J in two T steps, because I'll go back and forth, right? Right? So that means D of I divides T and D of J divides T. Well, it's true for any possible T, right, that we can have. So that implies D of I divides D of J, right? Okay. Is that fine or no? Is that fine?
Sir, can you tell me one more, sir?
See, I have taken some T, right? Such that PJJ of T is greater than 0. It's any T that you take.
Yes, sir.
All that I'm saying is D of I divides T and D of J divides T.
Yes, sir.
Right? So remember, okay, now let's collect all the T's, okay? So let's say T1 is 1 such T, T2 is 1 such T, and
sir,
all
DJs
that.
DJs are the GCD of all this T, no, sir?
Exactly, D of I divides all these, right?
Yes,
therefore, D of I is the GCD of all the T's. That is nothing but GCD of the node J, right? Which is nothing but D of J, right?
Yes, sir.
Is this clear? Therefore, D of I and D of J should be equal, right? Is that fine?
Yes, sir.
See, D of I divides T for any T such that PJJ of T is greater than 0. So what does that mean? It means that, well, it's not, sorry, I take this back. It is not GCD, right? It is just this. D of I divides this. So that means what? D of I is a divisor of T1 and T2, T3 and so on. Therefore, it is definitely less than or equal to
DJ, sir.
Right? Because
DJ
D of J is the greatest common divisor of T1, T2 and so on. This is a divisor, right? Therefore, it should be always less than or equal to D of J. How do you complete the proof now? I've shown D of I is less than or equal to D of J. So what is the other thing that I have to do?
So opposite inequality.
Exactly, right? You interchange the roles of I and J.
Yes, sir.
You'll get D of J is interchanging the roles of I and J gives D of J, sorry, less than or equal to D of I. So if you call 1 and 2, implies 1 and 2 implies D of I equal to D of J. So this results in the following theorem. I'll write the theorem and I'll ask if you have any for any Markov chain. Okay. So finite or countably infinite states with S countable. I'll write it like this. Okay, S countable. All states in the same class have the same period. All states in the same class have same period. For transient class, I'll assume the period to be infinity. Okay, I'll define it as infinity. So if you have a transient state in one class, all the other nodes are also transient. Therefore, all of them have infinite period. Okay, I think this should work. So is this clear? The proof is clear?
Yes, sir. So in this theorem, sir, should we define class as a recurrent class, especially should we mention or not, sir? Or only class will be enough?
Not really, right? So see, you take any class. If it's a transient, if the node is transient, all the nodes in the class are transient.
Yes.
Right?
Sir, yes,
what
sir.
Is the GCD of each one of them? Infinity, right? So it will never come back. Right?
Okay, sir.
Or is it if it is transient, what will happen? So is that correct to say that it is infinity, it will never come back?
Yes, sir. I think, yeah.
See, P, okay, let's look at, not really, right? It doesn't look
sir, like. Actually, we can't define there also something like this.
Oh, for example, if you look at 1, right? So starting at 1, I have to come back to 1 in one step, which is 1 by 4. Two steps. There are two paths, right? 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 1 by 4, and then another 1 by 4. So it's 1 by 2. The probability that I come back in two steps is 1 by 4. Three steps, I go to 1, stay 0, stay in 0 for 2 time instance and come back. So it will be 1 by 8, right? Three steps. Four steps is 1 by 2 power 4. So n step is 2 power. So it's actually... the period is it has it's aperiodic state, right? It's aperiodic because the GCD is one.
Yes, sir. One
definition. So you cannot say that it is the GCD is infinity. The GCD is one. It's called transient because at some point in time it will go out and will never visit. Okay. There is a non-zero probability of that happening. So when that happens, then with the non-zero probability, you may not come back. That means if you look at the long run, with probability one, you will not come back. Okay. Is this fine? Do you have any questions regarding this?
No, sir.
Huh? So others, is the proof clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. So Rishabh.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Raveen.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what is the big picture now? So we have seen that if you have a Markov chain if you have a communicating class, and if a node has certain period, then everyone will have the same period. Okay. Now. Suppose I have a Markov chain, okay, where all the nodes are recurrent. Okay, all the nodes are recurrent. Is that fine? If all the nodes are recurrent and they have the same period, okay, and the period is one, what does that mean? It's aperiodic, right? So you have all the nodes like this and all of them can communicate with each other, and it's one big class, and the period is one. Therefore, it can, you know what that means. It's aperiodic and recurrent. What will happen? So if you start at node I, okay? So I can reach any node in some k steps. Do you agree? With non-zero probability, right? If you run this Markov chain enough, what will happen? I start at node I, let's say, I'll wander around, and then at some point in time I'll reach j, and then I'll wander around lot of times, right? Infinitely many times, and then I'll enter something, right? Let's say l, state l. After wandering lot of time, I'll state l. Now what has happened? You started at I, wandered around and reached j, and then wandered on. Given that you started at j, because of memoryless property, right, of Markov chain. It forgets. So it is as if you are starting your chain, starting from J and see what happens, right? So it doesn't matter where you start, right? In the long run, this Markov chain looks like it doesn't matter where you start. It matters where you end. If you're asking the question of whether I will end at state L after a long period of time, you should not depend on where you started, right? Intuitively, this is what it says, right? Do you agree? Everyone? Ayush, do you agree with this?
Yes, yes, sir.
Right? So that means if you look at PIJ after N steps, so this kind of goes to, in the limit, some, it should not depend on where I started. It should not depend on J. It should depend on only on J. Let me call that as pi J. And it should also not depend on N, because anyway you are taking N to infinity, right? So after a long time, it will go to pi J. That means if you look at PIJ, it goes to pi J, right? It only depends on the column index, not on the row. All the rows will be same, right? The entire row, each term will go to pi J, right? So the whole matrix will go to constant row matrix. Do you agree? That's what it does.
This is essentially the definition of the Markov, right?
No.
It will not depend on the previous steps.
It's the previous. I'm talking about the long run, right? After N step, where N is billion, let's say. Okay. Right? So it doesn't talk about what happens immediately. It talks about long term, right? If I wait enough, it will kind of forget where it started. It only matters where it ends. And the probability that you end up in J is pi J. Do you agree?
Sir, this is happening within a communicating class, right?
I said this communicating class is one communicating class because all of them are recurrent states. So if all of them are recurrent and the period is one, then it belongs to one class, right? That is aperiodic and recurrent. It belongs to one class, then it doesn't matter where you start. It matters where you end. Okay?
And so another thing, sir, the definition of Markov doesn't do anything with recurrence.
No.
And Yeah.
Well, it doesn't say anything about recurrent or anything. Well, it implies, but doesn't say much. Well, it implies, right? Looking at the probability transition matrix, you can say whether a state is recurrent or not.
Right? Yeah.
So, for example, if you have something like this, right? 0, 1, 2. So, let's say half. Okay. Well, all the states are recurrent. All the states have a periodicity of one. That means aperiodic. It belongs to one communicating class. So if you let this chain run, right, after a long time, it doesn't matter where it started. It just matters what fraction of the time it spends in each node. That gives me pi j, right? Pi zero is the fraction of the times you spend in state zero in the long run, right? That's what matters. Do you agree? How much time, meaning how many times you visit state zero in the long run? Intuitively, you can see one third of the time you should spend in zero, one third of the time you should spend in one, and one third of the time you should spend in two. That's all from this, right? By symmetry. Do you agree? There is no bias towards any state, right?
That means it will tend to uniform distribution.
Exactly, right? It tends to uniform. So pi j tend to be uniform, right? So that means if you have such a Markov chain, you don't need to worry about what happens in the long run, right? If it turns out to be 1/3, then everything works out. Okay? Okay, anyway, so I'll discuss this in more detail in the next class. Is that okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay. Okay, I'll stop here. We decided to have a test tomorrow, right?
Yes, sir.
17th evening, I'll start. Huh? Is that okay,
okay,
everyone?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
You have any?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So I'll let's have a test tomorrow. this test will be simple, and Savan will communicate the logistics. Okay, so either it will start tomorrow evening or worst case day after tomorrow morning. You will have 24 hours as usual. Okay, is that fine?
So tomorrow morning. Tomorrow morning.
No, not tomorrow morning. Day after tomorrow morning. Tomorrow evening or day after tomorrow morning. Okay.
Okay.
So one of the two, and you'll have 24 hours.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thanks. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.